Amen. And even in the Sunday school lesson, the poll said something about my message. I was like, where they get out my message? But you know what? That was the Holy Ghost letting me know. It's on time. Amen. Amen and amen. Sometimes you want God to come through and speak to your heart. Amen. I had many messages I could have preached from. I said, let's see what I've been going through, talking about. Amen. This was not one I did really think of. Amen. I had one called Church Folks Gone Wild. It's a blueprint of our life. Amen. I ain't got there yet. I know I just wrote that one. It didn't really resonate with my spirit. And I was thinking, yeah, we got some cooks in here. Amen?
Amen.
And you know, when you really cooking, fixing to cook, you get out your good pots. Amen. Your good pots that you don't want nobody else to use. Amen. Sometimes when you use your good pots, even when you just wash them out and everything, they still have that residue in it. And it still smells like greens or baked chicken or whatever. And I just wondered, I done washed it, I done sterilized it, I done pureed it down. But the Holy Ghost said, you know, sometimes you need that residue to stay right there.
Well.
So you won't forget.
Amen.
What God has done for you. Amen. Anybody got one of them cast iron skillets, you know it's black. And you know you don't wash it out. You put some oil in it and you wipe it out. I guess y'all don't have no iron
skillets.
Amen. And I very seldom pull it out, but when I put it out, it's on.
All right.
Amen. Amen. I thank God for the word.
Work on it.
Thank God for the word.
Yes.
Amen. We're going to try to eat some healthy food today. Is that all right?
All right.
Amen. I think I told you just a while ago. Me and Pastor Griffin, we a church all week long. A lot of time.
Yeah.
Like I'm running rag. Like I need some pick-me-up, some vitamins.
All right.
Amen. But I'm yes saying
yes.
On God's word.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. I'm going to try to get it out the best way I can. We're going to be jumping all over. How about that?
All right. Work on it.
Okay. I wrote it down like I said, so y'all know me. I'm country. Thank you for the Lord. I wrote it down like this. I need to go to the hospital. Or I need to go to the emergency room, but I'm having a hospital experience. So y'all can put it the way y'all want to put it. Amen? But how many know the church is the hospital?
Right.
Yes.
Amen. It's supposed to heal you while you're here. Amen. And when you go to the hospital, you don't want to go back the same way you came. I don't think so. Amen. That's what people go to the hospital for. Or, I'm going to say it like this. Some of y'all are going to Carolina to get a quick fix.
Well.
Is it
primary care now, or emergency now.
And I remember incident that me and Pastor Draper went to emergency now. And he was saying what I was saying, and I was saying what he said. If I know all this, I just went to the emergency room.
Right.
Because we couldn't get no help nowhere. Amen. So we went on down to another place again. And when I even got out of the foster home, they asked me, what do you need? I said, well, my mother has failed, and we need a wheelchair. They just turned me around real quick. We don't do that here. So I told Pastor Draper, we should have went on to Amen. Why? Word is mine told us. Amen. Sometimes you're going to have to bypass the primary care.
Right.
Care now. The quick fix to get on to the hospital.
All right.
Or the emergency room.
Right.
Amen. But we do know that emergency room is acute care plan.
Uh-huh.
Amen. They are there to help you in a little of your need.
Right.
I said a little.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. They cannot operate on you. I ain't seen one do it yet.
Mm-hmm.
They cannot operate on you.
Yes.
Amen. They can fix it. They can bandage it up. They can give you a band-aid. They can give you a arm thing. They can give you a leg thing.
Right.
Amen. They can give you some shots.
Right.
But the hospital
yes.
is a place where you can stay
mm-hmm.
and get some healing.
Right.
But sometimes you just want you to stay. Amen.
Amen.
You want to stay there. Because sometimes we come to the hospital, so if they moving fast enough and we've been in emergency rooms, we get mad and we leave.
Right.
Yes.
Amen. And sometimes you need to stay there a little while longer
uh-huh.
just to get your needs met.
Right, right.
Amen.
All right.
So I'm going to go to some scriptures. I know y'all say, what you going to
do? You work okay. it. Work on it.
I'm going to go ahead and give you all my scriptures and then we'll go there. Amen. James 5:14, Mark 2:4, Luke 5:17, and Jeremiah 8:20. I'm going to go to Jeremiah first. But I just want to teach y'all the scriptures on that. Jeremiah 8:20. Mm-hmm. Then my story, I'll read them down. Luke 5:17. Mark 2:4. James 5:14. And I even throw the scripture in Matthew 9:9. So that's what I'm saying. I'm going to go back and forth, y'all.
Alright.
So y'all just bear with me, okay? Thank you, Jesus. Some of y'all are in the emergency room right now when you should be in the hospital.
Hmm.
Some of y'all in the hospital need to be in the emergency room right now.
My Lord. Help us out.
Some of the stuff you can fix on your own.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah. Some of the stuff you can fix on your own.
Amen. Say that again.
Amen. You can fix on your own. Don't go to sleep now. Amen. Pastor don't try to boost you and encourage you. And some of y'all, like I said, you don't know when to praise God.
All right.
Thank
yes,
you,
Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Amen. Jeremiah 8:20.
Mm-hmm.
It says, the harvest is past. The summer is ended. And we are not saved. I'll say it again. The harvest is past.
Yes, come on.
The summer is ended.
Yes.
And we are not saved.
Yes.
My mm-hmm. God.
The work is at.
But you're at the hospital still.
Come on.
Jesus. Hmm.
Some of y'all left the hospital and went to hospital care. You're in bad shape.
Amen.
And I go down to 21 verse says, for the hurt of the daughter of my people and my hurt.
Yes.
I am black. Astonishment has taken hold of me. Is there not a bomb in Gilead?
Huh.
Is there no physician there?
Yes.
When then is not the health of the daughter of my people recovered?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
He asked a question. Is there not a physician there?
Yes.
It is there. Some of y'all just don't want to be saved.
Come on.
But you want the word of hell out of us to pray you do. What you do.
All right.
Stay on the altar.
Yes.
Yes.
We don't mind assisting you.
Mm-hmm.
Pastor Draper is a doctor. I'm just a nurse. He's a chief doctor. All right. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Ghost.
Jesus.
The summer has passed.
Mm-hmm.
And you still not saved.
Mm-hmm.
You still ain't doing no better. We finna go into the, what's this fall coming up? Fall is coming. Some of y'all still lacking in January.
Wow.
And we wonder why God has not talked to you. Mm-hmm. He can't talk to you when you're full of hell.
Amen.
Can't get nothing through.
Help us.
He can't talk to you if you don't want to listen to nobody. He can't talk to you when you're always talking.
Right. Jesus, Jesus.
He can't talk to you if you ain't never come to church. What is he going to say to you? If you say you are saved folks go to church.
Amen.
Christians, whatever y'all call yourself these days, everybody say now.
Amen.
They go to church. And they want something from God. When I go to prayer meeting, I want something from God. But lay down. And somebody has to assist you, help you,
Mama.
If I need to help, I want somebody to come and help me.
Yes.
Because I don't want to be paralyzed no more. You paralyzed me a dangerous time.
Yes.
You sitting on your feet looking at everybody praise God.
Amen.
And you act like God is getting nothing for you. If he woke you up, he did something
good. Right.
If you were feeding yourself, he did something good.
Yes.
If you were healing your body, praying off, he did something good.
Yes.
All right.
I know you're right.
Thank you, Jesus.
Bless your name, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
Or some of y'all sitting in the emergency room with a headache.
Yes.
What's a headache?
All right.
Well, you can take the aspirin and keep on taking.
All right. All right. All right. Work on us. Work on us.
When you can take some, you ain't got to go to the emergency room for a headache.
All right. All right now.
Sometimes we have a mask on because we're full of mess.
Yes. All right. Help us.
And we can let the mess go.
All right. Yes.
And we hold on to it. We come to church with it.
Yes.
We wake up with it. We go to bed with it. We go to our God with it.
Woo!
Jesus. And you wonder why your family is saying, they don't get saved.
Amen. Oh, the gospel.
Because they see all the hell in you.
Yeah. All right now.
They see you ain't delivered.
Amen. My God.
They see you talking about the church.
Amen. 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 Thank you, Jesus.
But you still sit in the mercy room.
Come on.
Then you go to the emergency room because your feet hurt.
Mm.
When you need to be going to the foot doctor.
All right.
He can tell you what's wrong with your foot.
That's right.
He can tell you got a spur in your bone.
Uh-huh.
And when you get there, you tell people, I got a hurt on my foot.
Mm-hmm.
And they look at you like, why you didn't go to the foot doctor? And they look at it, it looks pretty fine to me. What's wrong with it? It's got a heel spur in, I believe that's what we call it.
Uh-huh.
Where you can't wear a shoe when your feet is very tender.
Uh-huh.
Very tender. Uh-huh. But time is time to go to the mall, your feet ain't hurt no more.
My.
When it's time to travel, your feet ain't hurt no more.
My Lord, that's what you know.
When it's time to do your dirt, it ain't hurt no more.
All right.
When you go out places with them same feet, when you ain't supposed to be, it ain't hurt no more. Thank you, Jesus. But when you come down to church, it's hurting. It's hurting. It's hurting. I'm going to use my daughter for example, but sometimes she be trying to trick me. But a mother knows their children.
Yeah, they should.
Yes. Pastor, when she say, oh, my stomach hurt. I said, come lay on me, Zoe. She laying on me. But she hurt it, right? But she listened to the music. I said, you're not that sick. If you sick, you won't listen to no music.
Uh-huh.
You want some quietness.
Amen. You preach it too.
You want some quietness.
Amen. I do.
Then her stomach not hurting. And I said, well, I'm going to cook me this. I'm not hungry. Okay. Come there. I'm going to go back and I'm going to do something else. And I said, something missing off my plate. Oh, I ate a little. I said, you're not that sick. You're not that sick, Joel. Thank you, Jesus. Sometimes, even when she goes to school, my stomach hurt. You think we can stay at home? No, we can't stay at home.
Amen. You preaching.
Did you throw up? No, ma'am. Did you use the bathroom? Yes, ma'am. How you feel? Oh, that's what she do.
Work on us.
But brother, brother, the Bible says, know them that labor among you.
All right. Yeah, know them.
That's the word.
Mm-hmm.
Know them. You be around a person long enough, you ought to be able to study them. Know what they like, know what they dislike, know when something will trigger them, pop them off, or whatever. You ought to know that.
That's right.
Sometimes people don't even know their own family.
Yeah.
And they deal with them every day. I know just as good when Deacon Luckey is mad when he comes to that job.
That's it, man.
And I find his spirit.
All right.
When I find it, he get right. Okay? Thank you, Jesus. But the men of God here in Mark, now, was talking about the man that was sick. And how they heard Jesus was coming, so they wanted to get to him. When they got there, it was so
Yes.
So they say, well, how are we going to get him to Jesus? How are we going to get him to Jesus?
Mm-hmm.
One and two make what? I can't hear you.
Three.
Yes.
And so them three men, the 4 men, or whatever it was, they thought of a plan. Somebody's going to get on the roof.
Uh-huh.
We're going to take the roof off. I know enough of the word, but the word will be in your heart.
Right.
Amen.
Amen. I might not know where the scripture is, but I know the word.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Amen. Luke 5:17, I'm sorry, right there, it says, and it came to pass on a certain day, as he was teaching, that there was a Pharisees and doctors.
Uh-huh.
I'm going to say that again. And it came to pass on a certain day, as he was teaching, there was Pharisees and doctors of the law sitting by, which were come out of every town of Galilee and Judea and Jerusalem. And the power of the Lord was present, healed them. It said the power of the Lord was present and it healed them. It didn't say he laid hands. It said the power.
Uh-huh.
Okay, we going to James. Lady Draper, if you have that, can you read that?
James
5:14. I think you might have to read down.
Yes. Is any sick among you? Let him call for the elders of the church. Is any sick among you? Let him call for the elders of the church.
And it says the dog. It said that who?
Him.
Him is being you.
Mm-hmm.
It said let him call for the elders of the church.
Wow.
When y'all call, you tell them about the sad story. Get on to the point. My heart is failing me.
Yes.
And I need you to pray.
Yes.
I don't care. I say it all the time. I know some of y'all like dogs. And I don't have a problem with dogs. But you tell them about the dog. You tell them about then when you went down there, the dog went this way, then you went this way. I'm having a heart attack, so I need to tell them about the heart attack.
Right.
I need to tell Pastor Draper, I'm going into a cardiac arrest.
Right.
And I need you to pray right now.
Right.
You need to read this. No, stop telling the doctor what he needs to do. You need to do it.
All right.
You ain't the doctor. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
Then you need, you in a hospital. Then you got to have major surgery. Sister Draper. Major surgery. To try to fix that messed up heart. That iniquitous heart. Them hidden things you want to talk about.